Hey guys, it's Puxbro. Welcome back to another video. Today in Fallout 76, I'm going to be going over camp shelters, and I'm going to pretty much showcase the camp shelters in-game, how to get started with camp shelters, the quest line, how to actually like build in your camp, just kind of like what it looks like, and I'll go ahead and talk about some of the details of the camp shelters and how it's different from like our regular camp. So, let's go ahead and get started. You'll notice that after logging in to the server, you'll also get a quest line that automatically starts for you for the Brotherhood of Steel. So if you're interested in doing the Brotherhood of Steel quest line, that's how you can kick things off. But we're here for the shelters, so now let's go ahead and head to the Claim Center. The Claim Center is going to be all the way in the top left of the map, and it's going to be right here on the map, kind of above this 94. And in terms of Vault 76, it's going to be up in this direction. So let's go ahead and head there now. Alright, so I have arrived at the area and you can see visit the Shelter's Claim Center. And so now we are at Vault 51. So this is going to be the location, and Vault 51 actually has a fast travel area now. So once you discover it, or if you already have discovered it, you can fast travel to Vault 51 for free. And you can also start the quest line from Vault 51. So if you want, you can already head up to Vault 51 and get the quest line started. But we can go ahead and enter the Shelter's Claim Center. Alright, and once we're inside, the home quest is gonna, home expansion is gonna start. Welcome to the Shelter's Claim Center, claim your shelter now to expand your home. And we just need to talk to Mr. Clark. That's right, my free shelter. Alright, so now we just go ahead and go to the register behind here. And from here, we can go ahead and do Shelter Owner Registration System. And then we can do Register New Owner. And then we can go ahead and register. There we go, and now we can just speak back to Mr. Clark. Let's go, Mr. Clark. There we go. So we get materials and a free shelter. And then let's go ahead and say there isn't anything else I need to know. And then there we go. So the quest is completed. We get some caps like the usual. And you can see as part of the item reward, we get Vault Utility Room Shelter. So that's going to be our free shelter that the game is going to offer to you. At the moment, there's only three shelter sizes. So there's going to be like pretty much a free small shelter, which is what we just received. There's going to be a medium size shelter for Fallout First members only, and then there's going to be a large shelter, which will be for Adams. The medium shelter will be available for Adams for everybody at a later time, but initially it's going to be for Fallout First members first. All right, now I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate the shelters at my camp, and we'll go ahead and talk a little bit about shelters and how they work. So now that I'm at my camp, I'm going to go ahead and open up the build menu, and then we can go ahead and find the new tab. And the last tab is going to be shelters, and you can see right here, I now have the Vault Utility Room entrance, so we can go ahead and place this anywhere. And you can see it places on dirt, it places on pretty much any flat surface, so it doesn't have to only be dirt, it can be on platforms or flooring as well. It kind of sticks out a bit though. It honestly looks a bit better in dirt. At least this one, so I'm gonna maybe place it in dirt. We'll just place it here for now. Alright, and just like that, we place it, and it's cost me only one concrete and two steel, so it's pretty affordable. And then from here, now we can just go ahead and enter my shelter. Really quick, I just want to say that the shelters are all instanced, so once you go inside, it's going to be as if you're going into a building. There's going to be a loading screen, and that allows for the camp budget to be much larger than it is out on the server world, because there's no loading screen to access a regular camp like this. So they said that even the smallest shelter has more camp budget than your regular camp, which is really crazy to me. So let's go ahead and hop inside. That is good to know. So if you don't have pacifist mode on, then PvP interactions and death may occur inside shelters. And when you move your camp, usually you have to like rebuild everything unless you blueprinted certain parts, but with shelters, they're pretty much always going to be saved. So wherever you move, your shelter will always be, you won't have to rebuild your shelter. And this is going to be what the free shelter looks like as we enter. There's like this little lobby floor, and there's actually going to be a panel back here. And this is the control panel. This panel allows us to actually prepare our structures, and we can also enter the build mode. And in shelters, as you can see, some building rules have been removed, such as in the bottom left, you can see toggle snapping on and off. That's going to be a shelters only thing. It allows us to be more particular and more specific with how we want to place things, and it doesn't always have to snap. it gives us a lot more freedom with crafting and building. And you can see that if I go all the way here to go to stored, the shelter stored is going to be different from camp stored. So I have quite a bit of things stored in my camp, but they're not going to be transferring over to the shelter. So I have nothing stored in the shelters. And this is what the initial free shelter looks like. It's a pretty decent space. For the most part, it looks like you can't really place flooring except for like upper floors. And you know, walls will still snap, but like if I toggle snapping off, then you could place it like this, you know, just for example. And this is like completely not snapped, but it allows for that freedom. And you can also see that we have some new core vault walls on the walls. These are just given to us. You can see right here, these two. And for floors, let me see if they gave us any new floors. No new floors, walls, roofs. They also gave us a new stairs, which is going to be a more vault kind of themed stair. Looks pretty nice. And for doors, they gave us a vault door. So if we wanted to, you know, have a vault door, we could do that. We also have some like vault looking railings, small railings, medium railings, like corners and all that. We also have a vault power bank, so I guess this is just to make power a bit easier to have in the vault. We also have this welcome mat, which I'm guessing is also new. Looks like a vault tech welcome mat. Just trying to go through and see all of the new things. I might have missed something, but I think that's pretty much everything for all the new items that they added. This is where you can purchase the shelters, and we already have the vault utility room, which is given to us for free. And then later we'll have the other two rooms, but I don't think they're available because Steel Dawn already released early, so this stuff will probably be available December 1st. So come December 1st, you can most likely go ahead and pick up the new shelters or the bigger shelters, but for now, this is what you pretty much get for free. And that's gonna be pretty much it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please let me know in the comment section below. Hopefully I didn't really miss anything. If there is anything I missed, please feel free to mention it in the comment section. Or if you have any questions, go ahead and let me know. But yeah, that's gonna be pretty much it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed. Until next time.